everyone, welcome to the next session on operations research. In this session, we will discuss another problem on the topic of traveling salesman problem, which is a type of assignment model. A salesman has to visit five cities A, B, C, D, and E. The distance in kilometers between the cities are as follows. We have to solve for it. So these are the salesmen A to E. These are the cities A to E, five of them. So it is a balance problem. Also, there are certain restrictions given, like the salesman cannot go from his own city to the same city. So A to A, no allocation, B to B, no allocation, and similarly up to E to E. The values in these cells are the distances in kilometers. So we need to figure out the shortest distance in kilometers that the traveling salesman has to cover. We have to remember that the salesman will start from a particular city, go through the other cities, and finally get back to his own city. So we will start with the first step. For that, we will first calculate the row minimum. We want to have one zero at least in each row and each column. So right now we don't have that, so we are going for calculating row minimum, that is 2 2. Here it is 4, this is 2, and this is 3. So I'll go for step 1, row minimization. Now we'll subtract the minimum value 2 from each value in the row. So this is 1, this is 4, 0, 1, this is 1, 3. This is 0, 1. Now we have 1, 0 in each row. So let's check for the column. The third column does not have a 0. The minimum value is 1. And others have at least 1 0. So what I'm doing is I'm calculating the minimum value of the columns. So step 2 is column minimization. We'll copy the first, second, fourth, and the fifth column as it is, and here I will subtract 1 from each value. So this will be 3, 2, dash, 3, 0. And now we'll copy the rest of the values. Now since there is 1, 0 in each row and column, I will go for step 3, which is calculation of penalty for all zeros. So now let's calculate the penalty for each zero. We will first check the zero. It is lying in which row and column? It is lying in the first row, fourth column. In the first row and fourth column, I will check, apart from the zero, what is the minimum number. So apart from the zero, minimum value is 1 in the row, and in the column it is 0. So this summation will be 0 plus 1, that is 1. That is the penalty of this zero. Next, in the second row, I have 1, 0. Apart from this 0, there is one more 0 in its corresponding column. And in corresponding row, the minimum value is 1. So, summation is 1. Third row, the 0 is there. In the corresponding column, minimum value is 1. In the corresponding row, minimum value is 1. So summation is 2. In the fourth row, the 0 has corresponding minimum value as 0 in the column and in the row also 0. Summation is 0. For this 0, 0 and 0 will make it 0. For this 0, again 0. And this 0, 0. For this 0, it is 0 plus 2, that is 2. So I have calculated penalty for each 0. Now you will have to figure out what is the maximum penalty. We have maximum penalty value as 2, that is present here and here. Now, randomly, you can choose any one. There is no rule. You will still get the same answer at the end. So, suppose if I choose this 2 as the maximum value. So I'll cancel out the corresponding row and column. I will allocate C to E. This is the allocation that I have made. Now I'll write down the reduced matrix by removing this column and this row value. So I'll write down step 4 is reduced matrix. What remains is A, B, C and D. And here what remains is A, B, D and E. Now, since I have allocated C to E that you saw, so E to C allocation will not be possible. So the first thing that I'll do is E to C, I'm going to write a dash over here and then I'll copy the rest of the numbers from the table ahead of it. So this will be dash 1, 3, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0, 0, 3, dash, 0, 0, and this is 3. I have not copied the penalty values. Now I will go for row and column scanning. Let me check if there is 1, 0 in each row and column. So this is 0, 0, 0, 0. This column does not have at least 1, 0. So the minimum value is 2. These are zeros. So what I have calculated is the column minimum. So again, I will have to write down a matrix. So I'll write down step 5. Now row minimization is not required because there is 1, 0 in each row. So I'll write down column minimization. I'm copying these column values. Here I'll subtract 2 from each number and again copy the rest of the values. So this is what I get. Now I'm going to calculate the penalty. So let's calculate the penalty for this 0. Minimum is 0 and 1, so 1. For this 0, in this column the value is 0 and row is 0. So this will be 0. For this 0 and 1, so this is 1. For this 0, 0, 0, 0. For this 0, 0, 0, 0. For this 1, in the row the value is 0, column the value is 0 and 0. So all these are taking value 0. So here we have calculated penalty for all zeros and maximum penalty value is 1. So you can either allocate this one or this one. What I'll do is I'll go for the corner value so that the table just becomes smaller. So I'm allocating A to D. So look here, D to A allocation in the next table has to be restricted. So I will go for the next table and I'll write the reduced matrix. If you want, you can write here, therefore D to A is not possible. So let's go for step 6. Again, we'll write the reduced matrix. We have ABC and BDE. I've written D to A not possible. Now D is here and A is here. So I will write down the first thing, that is this dash restricted. Then I'll copy the rest of the values. So this is 1, 0. This is 0 and 1. And this is 0, 0 and dash. So now you will have to check again the row and the column. There should be at least 1, 0. So there is 1, 0 in each row and in each column. So we can go for calculating the penalty. So for this 0, the minimum is 1, 1, so 2. For this, it is 1, 0, so 1. For this, it is 0, 0, 0. For this, it is 0 and 1, so it is 1. Now here, again, I'll write down calculating penalties for all zeros, maximum penalty value is 2. So obviously this is the allocation, that is B to C. That is a allocation. So next I'll write down step 7. That is again a reduced matrix. So this matrix now reduces to A, B, and here we have D and E. So we are at the end of the problem now because we will get all the allocations. So here I'll write down dash 0, 0, 0. Now obviously here it is only one value and this is not there. For this it is 0 plus 0. For this it is 0. So now you can allocate with the help of this step. D cannot go to A. So D has to go to B. So again I'll write down calculating penalties for all zeros. We have D to B as the allocation that I make. So what remains is E to A. This is the remaining one. So now let's write down the optimal solution. Please check. Here you have D to B and B is going to C. We know one value E to A. So I'll just write somewhere here and keep E to A. We'll go a little ahead and we will see we had A to D. This was another value. So here I'll write down A to D and we know it is E to A. And here we know it is C to E. That is the last one. So C to E is the last value. So we will start with E. E to A to D to B to C. Now obviously the salesman will return back to his own city. So E is the last city. So this is the answer. Now we will write down the total minimum distance. So how do we read? E to A is 1, A to D is 2nd, D to B is 3rd, B to C is 4th, C to E is 5th. So that is how we are going to read from this main table. So the first one, E to A, 3. Then we have A to D, that is 2. Then we have D to B, 2. Then we have B to C, 5. And C to E, that is 4. Obviously, we will again not write E to E because you can see here E to E is restricted. So we will calculate now. The values are 3, 2, 2, 5 and 4. Summation is 16 kilometers. So this is my answer. So that's how you solve a traveling salesman problem. With this, I end the session. I hope you have understood the numerical. If you have any doubts, please write to me in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon for latest video updates. See you in the next session. Thank you.